गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम राजविंदर कौर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन कंप्यूटर साइंस डिपार्टमेंट. आई विल टीच यू कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स सब्जेक्ट. माई टूडेज टॉपिक इज DDA एल्गोरिथम. DDA एल्गोरिथम स्टैंड्स फॉर डिजिटल डिफरेंशियल एनालाइजर. इट इज इंक्रीमेंटल मेथड ऑफ स्कैन कन्वर्शन ऑफ अ लाइन. In this method, calculation is performed at each step, but by using the results of previous one. Now, if two endpoints of a line are given, let's say these endpoints are x1 and y1, and x2 and y2. Now, we can draw a line with the help of DDA algorithm. But we first calculate the all intermediate points between these two endpoints. In DDA algorithm, we sample line at unit intervals in one coordinate and determine corresponding integer values nearest the line path for other coordinate. Now, we all know the equation of line is y equals to mx plus b, where m is the slope of a line and b is your y-intercept, right? M is your slope of a line and b is y-intercept. Now, if the endpoints of line are x1 and y1, and x2 and y2, then we can calculate the slope of the line. How we can calculate the slope of a line? It is represented by m, which is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. If these two are endpoints, x1 y1, x2 y2, then we will calculate y2 minus y1, then x2 minus x1. The equation of slope is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Now, if slope is less than equal to 1, there will be two cases. Slope can be less than equal to 1 or it can be greater than 1. If your slope is less than equal to 1, then we will put x2 minus x1 equals to 1 in this equation number 2, right? Now, by putting x2 minus x1 equals to 1, we get slope of line m is equal to y2 minus y1. We can represent y2 with the general format yk plus 1, because y2 is your next value and y1 is your previous value. So y2 can be represented by yk plus 1 and y1 can be represented with yk. Yk is your previous value and yk plus 1 is the next value. Now we can find the next value of y, that is yk plus 1 is equal to yk plus 1 from this equation, right? Now, whenever the slope is less than equal to 1, we change the x by 1. Means there will be a unit change in x. And we change the y by m. Means we calculate the x coordinate, next x coordinate, by adding 1 to previous value of x. And we can calculate the next value of y by adding m to the previous value of y, right? This is your case 1. Now, case 2. If slope of line m is greater than 1, then we will put y2 minus y1 equals to 1 in equation number 2. By putting y2 minus y1, we get m equals to 1 divided by x2 minus x1. By solving this equation, we get x2 minus x1 equals to 1 by m. Now shift x1 to the right side, we get x2 equals to 1 by m plus x1. In the same manner, x2 can be represented as xk plus 1, that is next value of x, and x1 is your previous value, so it can be represented by xk. So next value of x will be previous value of x plus 1 by m. Now in case 2, if slope is less greater than 1, then how x will be calculated? It will be calculated by adding 1 by m to the previous value of x. But how next y value will be calculated? We add 1 to previous value of y, right? Now this is algorithm. Using DDA algorithm, calculate the points between the starting point 5 and 6 and ending point 8 and 12. Firstly, x1 and y1 will be 5 and 6, x2 and y2 will be 8 and 12. Now calculate x2 minus x1. X2 minus x1 will be 3, because 8 minus 5 is 3. In the same manner, we can calculate delta y. Delta y means small change in y. Y2 minus y1. Y2 value is 12. 12 minus 6 is 6. Now slope of the line is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, or it can be written as delta y divided by delta x. That is small change in y divided by small change in x value. Now 6 divided by 3, we get 2. Here slope is greater than 1, so case 2 is satisfied. If slope is greater than 1, then we increment y by unit interval, and the next value of x will be calculated as xk plus 1 by m. The slope is 2, which is greater than 1. Now, next, this was my previous point 5 and 6, and my slope is greater than 1. Whenever slope is greater than 1, we will increment the value of y by 1. So previous value of y was 6, it will be incremented by 1, we get 7. But next value of x will be calculated by adding 1 by m to the previous value of x. Previous value was 5. 5 plus 1 by m, that is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is 0.5. 5 plus 0.5 will be the next value of x. So after rounding off my point, I will get x coordinate 6 and y coordinate 7. So this is my first point, first next point, 6 and 7. Now using these two previous value, I will calculate the next value of x and next value of y. Next value of x will be previous value plus 0.5, that is 1 by m, we get 6, fine. But the value of next y will be received by adding 1 to previous value, that is 7 plus 1 is 8. So next point will be 6 and 8. No need to round off, because there are no decimal points included in this equation. Now next point will be calculated as previous plus 0.5, that is 6 plus 0.5, we get 6.5, and y will be 9. After rounding off 6.5, we get 7, and next value of y is 9. Again, by using these previous value, we get the next value, as 7 and 10. Next value is 7.5 and 11. But by rounding off 7.5, we get 8. Now using this previous value, we can calculate next value of x, that is 7.5 plus 0.5, which is equal to 8, and y will be 12 by adding 1 to previous value. Now next point will be 8 and 12. Now this is my ending point. This was my starting point 5 and 6, and this is my end point 8 and 12. So these all are intermediate points. This is how we can draw a line between these two given points using intermediate points. Now take one another example. Using DDA algorithm, calculate the points between the starting point 5 and 6 and ending point 13 and 10. Again, we need to calculate the slope of a line, that is m, which is equal to delta y upon delta x. Delta y is your y2 minus y1. y2 minus y1 is 10 minus 6. 10 minus 6 is 4. In the same manner, delta x can be calculated as x2 minus x1, which is equal to 13 minus 5, which is 8. Now slope of a line will be delta y upon delta x, or you can say y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. This is equal to 4 divided by 8, and we get 0.5. Now this is your another case, that is case 1. Here slope is 0.5, which is less than 1. So we will increment x by unit interval, but y value will be calculated as yk plus m. We will add slope to the previous value of y so that we can get next value of y. Right? Now look at table. This is my previous value 5 and 6. Slope is 0.5, which is less than 1. So we will increment the x value by 1. So x value will be increased by 1. 6, then 7, then 8, then 9, 10, up to 13. Because my end value of x is 13. Now, y will be calculated by adding the slope to previous value. So next value of y will be calculated by adding 0.5 to previous value, that is 6. So 6 plus 0.5 is 6.5. But by rounding off this, we get 7. So your point, next point will be 6 and 7. By using this previous point, we can calculate the next point. X value will be 7. Y value will be, by adding 0.5 to previous value, that is 6.5 plus 0.5, which is equal to 7. So next coordinate will be 7 and 7. In the same manner, x next value of x will be 8, and next value of y will be 7 plus 0.5, which is equal to 7.5. By rounding off 7.5, we get 8. So next point will be 8,8. In the same manner, next x value will be 9 and y value will be 8. So next point will be 9 and 8. All these points can be calculated from previous points until we get the end point. So this is your DDA algorithm. The main advantage of DDA algorithm is it is easy to calculate. But main disadvantage of your DDA algorithm is we always need to round off the values, which takes time. So we can use another method of line drawing algorithm, which is Bresenham's line drawing algorithm, which we will discuss in our next class. Thank you.